Jesus said unto her, Didn't I tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God? John chapter 11, verse 40.
Our heart is hard.
And
our ear too is hard. Women are softer when it comes to the things of God.
Praise
the Lord.
Hallelujah.
As for men, when God moves us, we don't move. We are standing there like a botebri. The rock of ages. We don't move. May the Lord soften your husband for you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Faith is not equal to a shaking. Faith is not equal to a falling down. Faith is not equal to a scream. Faith is a substance.
Makes us anxious, worried, disturbed, makes us feel like our end has come.
A lot of the times
because we are ignorant. And the wisdom is not there. When the wisdom is there, and the knowledge is there, and the understanding is there, when the storm comes on the boat, on the sea, you will sleep in the boat. Because the wisdom is there, the knowledge is there, the understanding is there. When others are running head and scatter and they are worried, and they think that they will be destroyed.
Now, what do you say? Best
ever. You will be sleeping in the boat that Jesus was sleeping in. Because you know what you don't know. And you understand what they don't understand. Say, Holy Ghost, give me knowledge, give me wisdom, give me understanding. In the mighty name of Jesus. There was a king in Israel called Rehoboam. He took over from Solomon. When he took over from Solomon, some of the people that were under the leadership of Solomon came to Rehoboam, who is under king. Those who were being ruled by Solomon. Who is the king? They said, your father maltreated us. So reduce the load, reduce the
load.
When your father was president, he maltreated us. So now that you are taking over from your father, reduce our suffering. Reduce the punishment that you are taking us through.
And then
Rehoboam said he's going to consult.
So he
went to consult those that grew with his father. And he went to consult those who grew with him. And those who grew with his father told him that be gentle with the people.
Gentle with the people. And And
then those who grew with him told him that be rough with the people.
Now more money Rehoboam any and say when you mo basa
basa. He ignored the wisdom of those who grew with his fathers. And the elders.
And
he listened to what the younger people said.
Now I'm renting no dear no now fire.
So he was rough with the people.
And
out of the 12 tribes, he lost 10 tribes.
So
he was only left with 2 tribes.
Because
he didn't apply wisdom.
And
he didn't listen to godly counsel.
So
many of us, our influences are reduced. Our influences begins to shrink. Our level of lifting and progress begins to go down because we don't listen to counsel. There's no progress in our lives. We are not moving forward.
People who have gone ahead of us
in certain fields, they know things we don't know. So when they talk to us and we listen to them, it will help us. So our fathers are there, our mothers are there. They know a lot of things that we don't know. If we listen to their counsel, it shall be well with us. Especially when God gives you a godly father, a godly mother, a godly boss, a godly superior, you are blessed. These people will show you some directions, they will give you some counsel that will ensure that your tomorrow will be better and greater. So Rehoboam lost. Say Holy Ghost, deliver me from losing opportunities. Say Holy Ghost, deliver me from losing opportunities. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So it's very, very important. Most of our problems are wisdom problems. We create the problems ourselves because of lack of wisdom. And so our life begins to go down. Our life begins to shrink. The Bible says the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
Bible say,
and the knowledge of the holy is understanding.
The
knowledge of the holy is understanding. Proverbs chapter 9 verse 10. And so anybody who fears God, who respects God, will get wisdom.
Anybody
who does not book God, he does not book God, he does not regard God, he will not be able to walk in wisdom.
He will venture
into unwiseness, or he will venture into foolishness. But once you regard God, you respect God, when you hear the word of God, it shakes you. When you see something about God, you are very cautious. When you are such kind of people, you become wise and you don't mess up your life. Amen.
Amen.
But those who don't book God, those who don't regard God, they will waste their life.
Say,
I will respect God. Say, I will respect God. Amen.
Amen.
In Proverbs chapter 10 verse 13, the Bible says that in the lips of him that has understanding, wisdom is found. So a man of understanding will be wise. In the lips of him that hath understanding, wisdom is found. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So understanding will lead you into wisdom.
In
Proverbs chapter 10 verse 31. It says that the mouth of the just brings forth wisdom. The mouth of the just brings forth wisdom. And so when you become justified, or when you become a child of God, wisdom fills you. The justified are the people who are born again or who belong to God. So you cannot be a child of God and lack wisdom. You cannot be a child of God and lack wisdom. You cannot be a child of God and be taking decisions anyhow that will destroy your life.
He
says the one who is a child of God, wisdom is found in his mouth. May the wisdom of God in you be resurrected in
Jesus'
name. May the wisdom of God in you come alive in Jesus' name. May the wisdom of God that is lying down in your life be resurrected and be revived. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, say wisdom of God that is lying down in my life. Hear the word of the Lord. Come alive. Be revived. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
So we are just looking at some of the things that bring wisdom. In Proverbs 11 verse 2, it says that when pride comes, then shame will also come. But with the lowly or with the humble is wisdom. When pride comes, then shame will also come. But with the lowly or with the humble is wisdom.
So
humble people are wise. Humble people are wise. When we lose our humility, we venture into unwiseness. So wisdom is what enables you to properly apply your knowledge. Wisdom enables you to know the difference between two things. The difference between two persons. The difference between two natures. The difference between two creatures. The difference between any two different things. It's wisdom that enables you to know the difference. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So last week, we read from Proverbs chapter 8 from verse 11. And he said that wisdom is better than precious metals like gold and rubies and all those things. Last week we learned that wisdom has no comparison. We learned that a wise man is never weak, he's always strong. What discourages others does not discourage him. Because he has seen the end from the beginning. So in verse 15 of Proverbs chapter 8, he said, wisdom was speaking. He said that by means kings will reign and princes will decree justice. Verse 16, wisdom says that by me princes rule and nobles, even all the judges of the earth. Wisdom is saying that by me, I am the one that princes used to rule. Wisdom is used by princes to be able to rule. Before any prince will be able to rule, he has to use wisdom to rule.
And so
wisdom is indispensable to all rulers.
Yes,
wisdom is indispensable to all rulers. Once you are wise, all those who are on top, all those who control things, they will need you. Once you are wise, once you are walking in wisdom, all those who are at the helm of affairs, they will need you, because those people, they need counsel. They take decisions. So once you are walking in wisdom, you always be at the helm of rulership. You always be at the helm of affairs. You always be at the top, wherever you are. May you receive that wisdom in the name of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So wisdom will make you a dignified person. Wisdom will give you eminence in life. Wisdom will bring glory into your life. When you don't have wisdom, you become an insignificant person. Say, I am receiving that wisdom. Say, I am receiving that wisdom. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Once you are walking in wisdom, they cannot overlook you. Wisdom will make you a threat. And wisdom wisdom will make you a force because of the decisions that wisdom will make you to be taking.
So
whether you are in the military, whether you are in the judiciary, whether you are in the administration, once you have wisdom, you are a force in that place that you are. Because wisdom makes you a solution. So when elders and leaders are confused and you speak, wisdom brings clarity and direction and solution comes. Wisdom is very, very important in your life. Wisdom will advance your life. Wisdom will cause you to outshine. Wisdom will bring refinement into your life. Wisdom will make you prominent and it will make you the preferred person. It takes wisdom to become extraordinary. Say, Holy Ghost, the secrets of wisdom. Say, Holy Ghost, the secrets of wisdom. That will make me extraordinary. Manifest it in my life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Say, I declare by the spirit of wisdom, I will not be reduced. Say, I declare by the spirit of wisdom, I shall not go down. Say, I declare by the spirit of wisdom, I shall get better and better. In the mighty name of Jesus, say right now, by the spirit of wisdom, no situation can block me. Say, I declare by the spirit of wisdom, my case will not become worse. Say, I declare by the spirit of wisdom, I shall not deteriorate. In the mighty name of Jesus, say, I remove the impediment by the wisdom of God. I remove the obstruction by the wisdom of God. Say, I declare, I shall not be halted. I shall not be hindered because of the wisdom of God. In the mighty name of Jesus, say, I declare, I shall not be wretched because of the wisdom of God. In the name of Jesus. Amen. So, in verse 18 of Proverbs chapter 8.
See, Proverbs chapter 8, verse 18.
Wisdom says, riches and honor are with me. Yes, durable riches and righteousness. So wherever you think the riches are, they are not there. They are with wisdom. Wherever you think the riches and the honor are, they are not there. You are looking at the wrong place. They are with wisdom. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
For example, every Wednesday evening, when you are looking for somebody like Auntie Dinah or Mr. Dazzy, every Wednesday evening like this, or Auntie Gifty, you will find them with David Kakati in a place called Aman from Perez Chapel. Every Wednesday, when you are looking for them, you will find them there. So anytime you are looking for riches and honor, you find them where wisdom is located. Look for wisdom and you locate riches. Look for wisdom and you locate honor.
You
said, they are with me. They are with me. When you enter the single room where wisdom is located, you will find riches and honor there. They are always there. Wisdom is saying that the riches and the honor I bring, they are durable. They will last. They are durable. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So when you operate with wisdom, things will last in you. Become short-lived in your hands. Wisdom will ensure that that business will last in your hands. Wisdom will ensure that position will last in your hands. Wisdom will ensure that employment, you will not lose it too quickly.
Wisdom
will ensure that that woman or that man God has given to you, you will not lose him. It will last in your hand. It takes wisdom to work with troublesome bosses.
With that wisdom,
you will fight with your boss and you will lose your job unnecessarily.
That troublesome
boss has a solution. The solution is with wisdom.
When all other
employees cannot handle that boss, when you have wisdom and you meet that boss will become your body. He becomes your friend because wisdom has solved the complicated situation about that boss.
Abra, ejuma ya fon kind to me ne omunye ejuma. Ensansa wo wonya nsanti, ubetumi ene no ayejuma.
Say I'm receiving that wisdom.
Kasa me jesa nyansa.
In verse 19 he said that my fruit is better than gold.
O say ma ba eyesin sikakoko.
So wisdom produces fruitfulness. Every wise person will produce fruits. You cannot be walking in wisdom and be barren in life. My fruit is better. My revenue is better than choice saver. So wisdom produces revenue. He said, I lead in the way of righteousness. So wisdom brings leadership. Every wise person is an automatic leader. Wherever he is, he will be a leader. He will never be lost in the crowd. He said, I lead. Once you are walking in wisdom, you will lead. Wherever you are, in the class, you will lead.
In
the church, you will lead. In the department, you will lead.
I lead.
Wise people will lead. Praise God. I lead in the way of righteousness. So through wisdom, promote righteousness. Through wisdom, promote righteousness. That is why any suggestion that somebody brings to you, any idea that somebody brings to you, that promotes crookedness, that promotes ungodliness, that promotes confusion and division, it's not the wisdom of God. Through wisdom, promote righteousness. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
One day somebody came here. He said, I'm having a problem with my pastor. I want to come here. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
He said, if you do this thing for me, I'll leave my pastor and I'll come here. I told him that it is not godliness. Where you are to is a church. If you are coming here, you come here because there is food here. Not because I manipulate you and I turn you against your head, your pastor, and I pull you. No, that is not godliness. Am I communicating to somebody at all? So through wisdom,
we'll
lead a person in righteousness. That's why no godly wisdom will tell you to rise against your father, rise against your mother, and disrespect them. Wisdom will show you how to go around the situation. Am I communicating to somebody at all? And then he says in verse 21, I will cause those who love me to inherit substance.
Yes.
If you want to inherit things, wisdom is what will cause you to inherit. You inherit substance. People are struggling to get things and they are not getting it. Wisdom will cause you to inherit substance, not lighter things, substance.
Wisdom.
I will fill your treasures. I will make sure that your life and your destiny is not emptied. This is the spirit of wisdom speaking. Verse 23 says, I was set up from everlasting, from beginning or ever the earth was. He was trying to say that he had been there from TTTT before the earth was created.
He has been
around the Holy Spirit.
And
if you read verse 24 of Proverbs chapter 8, it says that Where there was no depths, God brought me forth. Where there were no fountains abounding with water, God brought me forth. Verse 25. Before the mountains were settled, before the hills were settled, God brought me forth. That's wisdom speaking.
Ansana yebesi bepono na oho.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Verse 26, it says that while as yet he had not made the earth, nor the fields, nor the highest part of the dust of the world, when he was preparing the mountains, I was there. When he set a compass upon the face of the earth, I was there.
I say, Abra, the
wisdom is very, very important.
Nyansa,
praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If you read Proverbs 24, verse 14. It says, so shall the knowledge of wisdom be unto thy soul. When you have found it, then there shall be a reward, and your expectation shall not be cut off. So when you encounter wisdom, your expectation will come to pass. Wisdom will deliver you from disappointment. Wisdom will ensure that your expectation is not aborted. He said, this is how the knowledge of wisdom shall be to your soul. He said, when you find the wisdom, when you find it, then there shall be a reward. People are looking for promotion. People are looking for reward. But it is not coming. The Bible says that when you find wisdom, then there shall be a reward. What you need is wisdom. Say, spirit of wisdom, make me sharp. Say, spirit of wisdom, make me sharp. The spirit of wisdom, make me smart. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In Proverbs chapter 8, verse 12, he said, I, wisdom, I dwell with prudence, and I find out knowledge of witty inventions. That's wisdom speaking. Proverbs chapter 8, verse 12. He says, I, wisdom, I dwell with prudence. Prudence is a form of wisdom. In fact, it's another name for wisdom, but it is a form of wisdom. He said, I dwell with prudence. And I find out knowledge of witty invention. So wisdom makes you an inventor. When you are wise, you are able to invent things. Wisdom enables you to originate things.
Yes.
What has not crossed people's mind? What has not crossed people's mind for them to do? Wisdom enables you to do it.
So
if you are in charge of the choir, if you are in charge of prayer department, or if you are in charge of any department in the bank or anywhere, what people have not done in that department before, when wisdom is at work in you and you take charge, you originate, you bring something new.
Stop
witty inventions, clever inventions. Clever inventions. When they put the thing in your hand, you change the dynamics of the whole thing. The way they have been doing it. You change it, not to retrogress the thing. You change it to better it and to enhance it. That is wisdom.
That is wisdom.
So it takes wisdom for you to work in creativity. Wisdom. Wisdom gives you ability to discover things. And to discover things, to unearth things, to uncover things, and to design things. Wisdom brings the designer in you. May you receive that wisdom in the name of Jesus Christ. I said, may you receive that wisdom in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Bible says that anything that was put into the hand of Joseph, it began to work. It began to prosper. That was wisdom at work. He was a slave. But whatever they put in his hand began to prosper, began to work. That was the spirit of wisdom. And the man fell in love with Joseph. He committed everything into the hands of Joseph. He said, I trust you with everything. Take it, manage it. That is wisdom. May you receive that same spirit of wisdom. I said, receive that same spirit of wisdom in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. When wisdom is not there, when they put this in your hand, they are afraid that you will spoil it. So every time they have to be monitoring you. The wisdom level is low.
So you always need supervision.
You need monitoring. But when they put the thing in your hand, they see Papa, how you are doing. They say, no, he has cut out her 7 pillars. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So wisdom makes you a pillar.
Seven
talks about perfect and completion. So it makes you a formidable, complete pillar. And wisdom enables you to build.
When
God put you into the hand of a wise man, he will build you and make you a very powerful person. I pray that all the friends that will come close to you by the spirit of wisdom, you will be able to build them. Allow yourself to be built. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
I was talking to you. He didn't listen to the elderly people. He went to listen to the young people. Young people don't have patience. They don't have tolerance. They think you are weak. Those who are wise and are a little elderly, they understand things. They take their time for people. Those of you who are young here, when little children are misbehaving, you are angry. Why won't the mother whip her? Why won't the father whip him? Those of you who are young, that is how you think. It's because you are young. You haven't grown yet. You haven't seen anything yet. Your wisdom level is down. Fathers and mothers, they can allow children to misbehave and they'll give the children chance to misbehave because their level of wisdom is there. They understand some things. Praise God. So if you are young, don't criticize older people. You haven't seen what they have seen. We have been there before. There are levels. It's not every discipline we give to children. There are levels. As they are growing, then you are increasing the discipline standard. As they are growing, then you are increasing. That when they are young, there are some things when you teach them, they can't grasp it. Give them chance.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. That is wisdom.
Amen. Amen.
Most of our problems are wisdom problems.
The
final scripture, Proverbs chapter 10, verse 21. The lips of the righteous feed many people, but fools die for want of wisdom.
They
die for lack of wisdom, for want of wisdom.
The reason
why they die. Fools, the reason why they die is because
they lack wisdom.
Lack of wisdom leads to premature death. Wisdom will prolong your life. Wisdom will postpone your death. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It's not everything that we use our face to go and face. There are some of the things you avoid it. When they wanted to kill Jesus, God could have just sent angel to clear them. He said, carry the little boy, run away to Egypt. Am I communicating at all? That is wisdom at work. God, this is the Son of God. He could have just sent one angel. He will clear all those soldiers. But God didn't. He said, carry the little boy, run to Egypt. There was a time the Bible said they wanted to kill Jesus. So he was not walking among the Jews again. He was walking among the Gentiles because they wanted to kill him. Not because he was not powerful. Not because he was not anointed. The wisdom of God was at work. So he was not walking among the Jews again. He started walking among the non-Jews because the Jews wanted to kill him. Wisdom will prolong your life. Wisdom. Wisdom will tell you this one. Some of the fight, leave it. Some of the insult, leave it. Praise God. You go and fight some fight, you regret. You said things you shouldn't have said. You have tarnished yourself. Some of the fight, walk away from it.
Like a cat will walk away from you.
That is the wisdom of God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Wisdom.
Nyansa.
That's why many people die before their time.
The
fools die because they lack wisdom.
Because
they lack wisdom. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We need to walk in this wisdom so that our lives will get better. Amen.
Amen.
Say, Holy Ghost, open my ears to hear the voice of wisdom. Say, Holy Ghost, when wisdom is speaking, open my ears to hear the voice of wisdom. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lift your voice and begin to appreciate God. Lift your voice and celebrate God. Lift your voice and worship Him. 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 Lift your voice and worship Him.
Declaring.